These implants are already osseo-integrated because of the forces the partial denture applies on the bone. A little bit of problematic cases.
Hi and welcome back to Uniqa Dental Show, where we discuss interesting cases and new procedures in the field of dentistry. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe and follow to stay tuned up to date. With us today, as always, is Dr. Yaniv. Hi.
Hi, how are you doing?
Amazing. How are you?
Great.
What did you bring for us today?
Well, today we brought a different case where the patient...
It's a new golden bridge?
Yeah, it's a golden bridge. The patient made a golden bridge. It's not a golden bridge, it's a stainless steel bridge with a titanium coating. It looks gold.
But it's new.
But it's not. Like it's, we're not talking about the golden bridge. Yeah, I understand that everyone wants to talk about this topic, but not. It's not the golden bridge.
It catches the eye.
Yeah, it catches the eye. You can see my smile in the bridge. It reflects. We want to talk about the lower teeth, the mandible. So, when she made the golden bridge, she also had her lower teeth made also. So in the lower teeth, she had a partial denture, also golden. Partial denture was on her frontal teeth, on both of the canines. She broke one of the canines. She had a huge periodontal problems with the partial denture and the teeth. And in this is when she came to us. We placed a couple of implants in the posterior parts. She was with the... We told her not to use the partial bridge because it can harm the implants because it applies a lot of pressure on the implants in the osseo-integration process. So in this case, she tried to eat with only those teeth that remained.
So you added those implants?
Yeah, the posterior
and
ones.
And you left her old bridge?
Yeah.
Just to... In the time that those get osseo-integrated.
Exactly. These implants are already osseo-integrated. We've added posterior to those implants, two implants in one side and one implant on the other side that didn't osseo-integrated because probably some forces were applied on this implant. When the whole osseo-integration process finished, we realized that she clenched her teeth and she's applying a lot of pressure and the golden bridge wearing off everything that we did, even the healing caps that were put on those implants. Later on, when the posterior implants also osseo-integrated, we took out the bridge, we extracted the teeth, and we've made a small bridge from a PMMA to hold in the meanwhile to give her some teeth to eat with. The posterior teeth were extracted a long time ago and she was with a partial denture, so she had a very large amount of bone loss and bone resorption. And there is no bone to place implants. You need to have very large augmentations. It's quite a problematic case in many cases when patients have a partial overdenture. You can see a very large amount of bone resorption because of the forces the partial denture applies on the bone. So in this case, because she had only the anterior implants, the anterior teeth, this is the only place that we can place the implants. So even in the best case scenario, the only teeth that she's gonna be with in the end is maybe from first molar to first molar, and probably from second molar to second molar. 10 teeth bridge. You can see here that she have a sleeve on top of the implant. It's because she broke the crown on the sleeve. She grinded her teeth very hard and she always breaks down some of the restoration.
I'm sure the upper metal teeth don't help in this situation.
No, they don't help. They wear off everything that we do.
Even zirconia?
Wear out. No, it won't wear out zirconia. But all the temporal bridges are made from PMMA, not from zirconia. So it can break the PMMA, it can wear the PMMA. Even the healing caps that we had before, it just wore off the healing cap and there was no hex in the healing cap in the end. You can see everything is breaking down in both sides.
So this is due to her grinding, right?
Yeah, this is due to her grinding. We still added one implant in the where she had left some bone, going above the mental nerve. We have a disangulation. We'll correct this angulation with angulated multi-unit abutment. You can see that the angulated implant is about 45 degree angulation. She have 6 implants, so even though she's grinding her teeth, she have quite enough rigidity for the bridge. When patient grinding her teeth or bruxism or clenching, you want to have as many implants as possible because you want to distribute the forces in the mouth a little bit on each implant. We placed all of these implants. We made a PMMA bridge. You can see the white color.
Another
on the
bridge,
one. Yeah. This bridge is on all of the implants.
I want to go back just one sec.
Yeah.
This 45 degree angle, it's on a V-type.
Yeah, it's on a straight multi-unit.
Straight multi-unit.
This case, because we have only one multi-unit angulated, and the V-type multi-unit are not fitted on the cone. It's a flat connection type. So even in little bit of problematic cases, when the angles are a little bit more than what you can have with straight multi-units, you still can use the V-type multi-units, and still you'll have great results in the fitting process. The most problematic part is the milling part, because when you mill on the V-type and you have very large angles, the milling machine can mill it. And because the milling machine is the problematic one with the angles. So in this case, we have 45 degrees between this one and probably those. Still millable, because you can mill up to 50, something like this. We used straight multi-unit, took impression on all of those implants, and then made a PMMA bridge and zirconia bridge. The zirconia bridge is very important here because due to the fact that she's grinding her teeth, you need to make the bridge from the strongest material possible. You can't, probably if you'll do a PFM or zirconia caps with ceramics, you'll have a problem. You have always chipping of the ceramics. You'll have different types of problems with these types of contractions. This why we made from monolithic zirconia. The color doesn't really matter because those types of patients prefer or the whitest as possible or golden.
Okay, so you use the zirconia because it's also one unit. It's not like porcelain fused to metal. It's two materials.
It's one material, very strong, that will hold in the grinding process. Now we closed the screw channels. We kept the screw channels as small as possible.
And you close it with pins?
Yeah, we close it with plastic pins. You insert to the plastic pin, the plastic itself melting down on the burr, and you can take the pin out with the burr. It's quite easy. As you can see, it takes a couple of seconds. Instead of inserting different types of materials to close the screw channel.
Oh, that's it?
Yeah, that's it.
Let me get the second part. We will see what you are doing with the golden teeth.
Yeah, we'll see how it will come to this.
Wait, do you take out the gold or you added more gold?
Right now, I have no idea what we're going to do, but we'll see how it lands up.
Depends on the gold price in the market.
Price in the market.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And thank you for being with us today. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and follow to stay tuned up to date. Thank you and have a great day.